Welcome. As that song so beautifully sung by Jillian Hassard reminds us, no one is alone. No one is alone, as just today we've been watching terrible devastation, floods, winds, tornadoes ravage Florida with Hurricane Irma. Last week, Hurricane Harvey in Texas, Hurricane Jose right behind, and terrible flooding taking place in Italy right now, and in Bangladesh right now, and earthquakes in Mexico right now. Those of us who produce the Pipes of Christmas realize that we had a role to play in all of this, that we needed to do our part to help out. And so that's what this broadcast and this evening with all of you is all about, is to remind us that no one is alone at this time. And we're delighted to be partnering with Hometown Television and with the Red Cross to put on this concert for you this evening. None of this happens without the incredible support of our home here for Pipes of Christmas for almost 20 years now, Central Presbyterian Church in Summit, New Jersey. And I'd like to begin the evening by asking the church pastor, Reverend Don Steele, to come and give a welcome to all of us and give us an opportunity to thank him for hosting us this evening. Reverend Steele.
It is really our honor to have you here this evening to be a part of this. It's a part of what we consider to be our reason to be, is to be of service to the community and a place where we can gather in times of difficulty to help others and to be a support. I'm reminded of Fred Rogers, Mr. Rogers' fame. He, like me, was from Pittsburgh. He, like me, was a Presbyterian minister. And he's got this quote. His mother told him when he was a child, he said, that in a time of catastrophe, when he was watching that unfold in a movie or on television, his mother told him to look for the helpers, because they would be there, maybe on the sidelines, but people who would be rushing in where there was a problem to help. Because he said, if you look for the helpers, that's where you'll find hope. Mr. Rogers was a wise man. And I would like to think that we look for the helpers and that we can be the helpers at times that bring hope where things can be dark and desperate. We're glad that you're here. We're glad that we're having folks join us by this broadcast and want to be a part of being the helpers in this situation. Thank you so much.
With that, we'd like to take a break down to the studio, and we're going to introduce our studio hosts for the evening, who will talk a little bit more about our fundraising efforts and the American Red Cross work in Florida right now. So, off to the studio.
Thank you so much. Welcome to the Hometown Television Studios. Thank you to the viewers watching us both on Hometown TV and on our on-demand service. I'm Shane Miller.
Good evening, and I'm Amy Prisbilko.
And we're thrilled to be with you tonight to raise money for the victims of the hurricanes that are happening throughout the country right now. But we've got a fantastic show for you, but we're hoping that this will inspire you to give. So while we're talking right now, go to redcross.org. You can also text 90999, text Harvey, and we're going to have an amazing show for you this evening, and I hope that it inspires you to give. Matter of fact, we just saw a great performance.
So our first performer was Jillian Hassert, who actually grew up in Summit. She has performed music and has a degree in opera from Carnegie Mellon University. She did such an amazing job.
That was fantastic. And Sondheim
is not easy.
An incredible
song. It's a beautiful song. I mean, it's one of those songs that you, when you hear and the way that she sung it, it really touches your heart, that we are all in this together.
Absolutely.
Right?
And accompanying her on piano was Mark Yalek. And we've got some great performers this evening. We have the Jubilation Choir, members from the Jubilation Choir. As you mentioned, Jillian Hassert and Wayne Mallett. We have pipers from the Rampart Lion Pipe Band.
Can't wait to hear them.
I know, the Scotch Highland Dancers, composer-guitarist Steve Gibb, Glenn Fittich, Scottish fiddle champion Callum Pasqua, Gaelic singer John Grimaldi, and we're going to hear more from the pianist Mark. So, and we are live tonight on Hometown TV, and I'd like to thank everybody at the Hometown Television Studios, everybody at the Central Presbyterian Church, for all they do for us all year long, and this is very exciting. We're also going to have a very special guest from the American Red Cross with us this evening.
And I can't wait to talk to her a bit about what the relief efforts are that are going on right now in Houston, in Texas, Louisiana, and what more is to come.
Absolutely. Yeah. And we have some special footage from the Red Cross that we'd like to share with you.
I'm Betsy Robertson at the George R. Brown Convention Center in downtown Houston. And over the last couple of hours, this facility has been filling with evacuees from the downtown area. As you can see, the number of people impacted and the need is tremendous here.
We had about 14 inches in our house last night. We're hoping that somebody would come along in a boat. We needed to get out because we know there's more rain coming. That's what they keep saying.
Major highways are already underwater and the rain keeps falling. But help is here and more is on the way. Take a look at the dormitory and the sheer number of cots and blankets that have been set up by the Red Cross, and you get an idea of the scope of this effort.
What stands out about this disaster is really the scale of it and the length of time that we're going to have to be prepared to afford assistance. We had thought maybe we'd have 5,000 people in this shelter, and we're now double that.
Yeah, I brought him some Tylenol. Yeah. Check on prescription medicine.
Today, I'm supervising one of the dormitory areas with a group of volunteers that are really helping people respond to any kind of particular personal need they have. So we're getting limited sleep and working long hours, but it's such satisfying work that we're eager to do it.
Find out how you can support these relief efforts by calling 1-800-RED-CROSS or visiting redcross.org.
Before I introduce the next act, a moment of meditation from the good book, Psalm 46, which seems appropriate today. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea. Though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. Nations are in uproar, kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice, the earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us, the God Jacob is our fortress. Come and see what the Lord has done, the desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. He says, "Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth." The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. May I introduce the great Rev Steph and Jubilation with spirit.
Thank you.
Rev Steph in jubilation. I'd like to hear one more song. Anybody else like to hear one more? Everyone reminds me it's a school night, but come on now. To close out their portion of the evening, we're going to perform for you, I'm Determined to Walk with Jesus. Rev Steph and Jubilation.
Yes, I am.
Fundraising, ladies and gentlemen. Bravo. We're going to revisit our friends in the studio, and we'll be back momentarily with more music.
I want to say a special thank you to Reverend Steph and Jubilation for the amazing music that they just performed for us up there. Now, Shane and I are sitting with Christy Hoddy, who is the Executive Director for the American Red Cross. Thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you for having me.
And the American Red Cross in New Jersey serves a population of 8.8 million people. In 2016 alone, they responded to 767 local disasters, helping 1,800 families displaced by home fires. They've collected more than almost 90,000 units of blood that year, trained 116,000 individuals in life-saving skills like CPR, and provided for military families all over the state. And the Red Cross is able to do this because of generous contributions to people like you. So before we start talking to Ms. Hoddy, go to redcross.org, make a donation, or text Harvey to 90999. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. It's a very special night for us.
It's a very special time to be here. Thank you.
How long have you been with the Red Cross?
I've been with Red Cross about 14 years. It's hard to believe.
And where are you located?
I actually have a couple of offices, but I am started out here in Summit, so Summit's been my home base for a long time, and I've now expanded. I'm now covering 7 counties, so I also have an office in Somerville and in Princeton.
So can you tell us a little bit about what you do sort of in the organization and part of your what your job entails?
Well, actually, I think when you stay with an organization long enough, you see your job change with really the demands of what the organization is going through. And we have done quite a lot of restructuring. We've adopted new business models, really, to the needs of our clients. And so there's much less staying in chapter houses and waiting for people mm-hmm. to come in. And we're really out in the communities. And that's where I see my role has expanded greatly. So I don't have to worry as much about the management of a facility. I'm really out being the face of the community and meeting people, creating partnerships, and really broadening our exposure and hopefully help to those that are needed.
And that's exactly what the Red Cross is doing right now. We've had quite a couple of weeks. It started out with Harvey down in Texas, and you were telling us before we went on the air that started weeks before the storm got there. Tell us a little bit about those preparations and what people are continuing to do down in Texas.
Well, I think people have to realize that the reason we do rely on donations is to be able to be prepared, because we can't, once a disaster hits, get to those people. So our deployment starts several days before. Sometimes it can be up to a week if we've got that kind of warning. But we do send volunteers. We do all call outs. Volunteers put in their accessibility, and they, by several means, get to the locations. They're setting up shelters, they're manning the emergency response vehicles, resources that are needed well before any massive storm hits, or even a minor storm, if it's going to be, those resources are going to be needed.
So when we're talking about the donations that you get, those resources go to gas for the emergency, is this, correct me if I'm wrong, but gas for emergency vehicles, food, setting up kitchens to feed people, maybe necessities, diapers.
Shelters,
setting up shelters. Are there other things that I'm missing where the Red Cross comes in and the donations help cover these?
Well, I think the two primary ones are we are recognized in our national response plan that we are the mass care leads. So that is sheltering and feeding. And that alone, if we can provide a safe place for people to go to and have the comforts, the basic comforts mm-hmm. that are necessary for themselves and their families and their pets, those are also viable parts of families, mm-hmm. then that's the largest part of our expense that I think that the donated dollars go to. And we've spent millions on sheltering and feeding people so far. It's been tens of thousands of people.
And that's just for Harvey, of course.
That's
now we're
just
in the midst of a second Hurricane Irma. And one of the remarkable things about the Red Cross is you are set up to handle two major disasters at a time. So how does that happen?
We wish it didn't.
Right, of course.
Irma being the largest storm the Atlantic Ocean has seen. So it is a double whammy for us. But we always have to keep something in reserve just for that circumstance. And you can't forget that we've been responding nightly to fires here in New Jersey. We just had a major fire in Patterson last night. And if we didn't have preparations and resources and volunteers who stayed back, then we really would not be able to take care of the needs that are immediate right here in the state. So yes, it is all hands on deck.
So if people want to help you here in New Jersey, what other than making a donation to the Red Cross at redcross.org, what can they volunteer? What can people do right here in Summit, Millburn, Short Hills?
Well, I think there are a couple things. We would love more volunteers. Obviously, we're being stretched to capacity.
Volunteers to go down to
Florida. Well, not necessarily. You know, get your training locally. The training is free, and then you can respond locally and sort of get your feet wet and learn the skills and the way Red Cross responds. And then certainly there are always opportunities with national disasters and for deployment. So, but we are fast tracking some people down to those areas if in fact that's really what they'd like to do. But I also think that it's really important to take that lesson of these disasters and think about your own family. Think about, are you prepared for an emergency? Have you taken CPR and basic first aid? Have you downloaded the apps that give you those kinds of emergency alerts? You know, take care of your family and your business first, and then please come and volunteer. We would love to have you.
Thank you.
Christine Hottie, thank you so much for joining us this evening. We're thrilled to be here to raise money for the Red Cross. And here's a little bit more info for you from the Red Cross.
We're a family of eight. It's myself and my husband, and we have six children that range in ages from 4.5 to 15. When they lowered those baskets and I saw the helicopters, it was such a sigh of relief for me. And we basically like tossed my kids over that rail so that the Coast Guard men could grab a hold of them and put them into the baskets. I believe I got my first CPR card through the American Red Cross when I was in nursing school. But personally, I had never had the help from the Red Cross until today. This blanket here kept me warm last night. I mean, I look around and this room is filled with hundreds and hundreds of people. And if you weren't here, I mean, who else would do this?
Welcome back. This is, if you're just joining us, this is our Hurricane Relief Concert entitled No One Is Alone. And it's my pleasure now to introduce to you, straight from New York City, the shot of Scotch Highland dancers accompanied by members of the Rampant Lion Pipe Band. Ladies. Thank you.
Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Bala Shelbyarnurai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Bala Kyantra. Tushir, Tushir, Tushir Holash. Tushir, Tushir, Tushir Holash. Tushir, Tushir, Tushir Holash. Vain Duahu, Sajaborai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balasher Bjarnarai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balakyantra. Frisharonai, Smurana Valai. Frisharonai, Smurana Valai. Frisharonai, Smurana Valai. Beindu achu sajavorai. Sarfum krimnish lirnish karnish. Sarfum krimnish lirnish karnish. Sarfum krimnish lirnish karnish. Beindu achu Sajaborai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balasher Bjarnarai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balakjantra. Sarfum krimnish lirnish karnish. Sarfum krimnish lirnish karnish. Sarfum krimnish lirnish karnish. Beindu achu sajaborai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balasher Bjarnarai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balakjantra. Movjanach hin, dohir nan lochen. Dohir an vreich, snandunja kosan. Do hir amai is barsta mohlak. Do hir mohrai farantavin sona. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balasher Bjarnarai. Oro Yulurai, Yulurai, Yulurai. Oro Yulurai, Balakjantra.
I want to say a special thank you to Bob Currie, who put this benefit together. No One Is Alone, A Concert of Hope. When I hear the sound of bagpipes, it's like a warrior's march.
There's something grand about that, for sure.
Yeah. Right, and, you know, inspirational.
Right. And we've got a little bit of everything tonight. We've got bagpipes, we've got choirs, we've got jugglers, and you've got us in the studio.
And a fiddler.
And a fiddler.
What more do you need?
Right, everything is
yes.
right here. And we
yes.
want to make sure that you know why we're here, which is because we want to raise money for the Red Cross. And so if you haven't already, please visit redcross.org. Please text 90999, text Harvey, and that will make an automatic $10 donation right from your cell phone. And we've got a lot of acts still coming up for you. We're so happy that you joined us this evening. What do we have coming up? I think coming up we have Mallett and Hassert. We heard Hassert sing No One Is Alone. But let's talk about Wayne Mallett for a minute. He is a teacher at Summit High School. He runs a lot of the choral programs over there. And you may have noticed this little Scottish theme that we have going on tonight, because he's also performed in Scotland. They performed with the Westfield Symphony. And did you know that there was a choir in Summit that performed on Law & Order SVU?
No.
I didn't know that. That's pretty amazing. And recently they sang the national anthem at MetLife Stadium, the choir at Summit High School. And that was all under Wayne Mallett's leadership, so we're going to hear them coming up.
And also, one other thing we have to look forward to is Bob Currie's talk, The Pipes of Christmas. That's something here at Central Presbyterian Church that you will definitely want to get your tickets for way in advance, because it usually is sold out. It is a really special event.
And that's right around Christmas time, once a year.
Yes, both here, and then there's also a concert in New York. And it's really something fun for the whole family to go and see. So
absolutely. And we just had a great interview with the executive director of Red Cross New Jersey. Christy was really informative. I didn't realize that anybody in the community could volunteer for the Red Cross. And you don't have to travel to Houston or to Florida. You can help right here. She was mentioning a fire in Patterson last night.
Right. And also another thing that I thought was so important for us all to take from that is to prepare. We know this is coming. And how you can prepare your homes and your family for the, you know, the catastrophes truly that happen in all of our communities, and just to be aware and be prepared.
And you know, I think we're in a new age because we've all went through Sandy, so we know that we have to take these things seriously. We didn't have, you know, a lot of people in this area didn't have power for weeks.
And you know, we know what it feels like.
Right. So one more time,
please
give all you can. Once again, you can text Harvey to 90999, and that will be a $10 deposit right from your cell phone bill. It'll only take you a second. Or you can go to redcross.org to donate or to find more information about volunteering. And while we're on the subject, here's some more information from the Red Cross.
My mom and dad accomplished the American dream and built a house for us and a working class family. But now it's all kind of come to an end today. These are actually my dad's gloves that we had framed when he built this house. And you know, we're still living the dream right now with all this help that we're getting.
There's a lot of gloves
now we're gonna frame. We are just so proud to be Houstonians, Texans.
After all the catastrophe, it's actually brought us all together.
This is a perfect example. The Red Cross just randomly came, just walked through our driveway, handed us something that we could use.
Cleaning supplies, water, tarps,
mosquito repellent, you know, toothbrushes, necessities, things that you don't even really think about until they're gone. And the Red Cross is giving that out without even asking. You're just showing up to people's doors, and that's going to mean so much to people, because the last thing some people are worried about is that they're just trying to salvage their house right now, and you guys are just making that so much easier for them. Just thank you Red Cross.
His face, I hear his heartbeat, I look in those eyes, how wise they seem. Well, when he is old enough, I will show him America, and he will ride on the wheels of a dream. down south.
Go down south.
And see your people.
See the folk.
Won't they take to him like cats to Currie? Then we'll travel on from there. Girl, and the times are starting to roll. Any man can get where he wants to if he's got some fire in his soul. We'll see Justice Sarah and plenty of men who will stand up and give us our due. Oh, Sarah, it's more than promises. Sarah, it must be true. A country that lets a man like me own a car, raise a child, build a life with you.
And Jillian Hassard, Wheels of a Dream, accompanied by Steve Gibb and Callum Pasqua. Bravo. Now we're going to bring you a little extra bit of Scotland. Pipe Major David Palladino, accompanied by Mark Yallet. And we bring you the eternal and wonderful Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
So Amazing Grace.
That just kind of puts you in the moment, especially, you know, tonight, tomorrow we're going to be, I don't want to say celebrating, but it's going to be the 16th anniversary of 9/11. And that always makes me feel that way. And, you know, it's interesting that it's this time of year that we seem to have these national tragedies, whether it's Houston or Florida.
It's heavy.
But there's one thing that's always in common.
Right.
The Red Cross is always there. And the Red Cross is always there to support victims no matter where they are in this country. And we hope that you will support them tonight. You can text Harvey to 90999. That will be a $10 donation. You won't even feel it. No amount is too little.
No, that's what I was going to say. Whatever you can donate, please, please donate. I know that I felt all day this, you know, I've been connected to my phone, to the TV, trying, you know, just feeling heavy, wanting to do something, right?
Right.
And, you know, what you can do is you can donate and you can give a small amount, and no small amount goes unnoticed.
That's
truly
true. And you can set up a very small recurring payment on redcross.org if you'd like. And the American Red Cross prevents and alleviates human suffering in the face of emergencies. That's their mission. And they do that by mobilizing the power of volunteers. And they can only do that with the generosity of donors. And that's why we're calling on you tonight to donate. We had a great conversation with Christine Hottie.
Right, who was basically talking about what the Red Cross does,
right,
and setting up shelters and providing food. And
right, and this is all before FEMA can even get there, right?
Right.
So
and
FEMA would provide the housing later, but you need shelter during the storm for some of these people, and that's what the Red Cross
does. Right, and to get there as immediately as you can.
Right. And, you know, there's a lot of charitable causes, but the Red Cross keeps people alive, keeps Americans alive, and that's why it's so important that you give as much as you can. And right now it looks like we're ready to move on with our concert, and we're going to send it back at upstairs.
Welcome back to No One Is Alone, our concert for hurricane relief fundraising efforts. We couldn't be in this beautiful hall without thinking about our beloved Pipes of Christmas and some of the great traditional music that we serve up every December. So we thought we'd give you a little taste of it. We found two of the best in the world for you, direct from Inverness, Scotland, not related to the Gibb brothers, but a Gibb himself, Mr. Steve Gibb on guitar. And if you've been to Jersey Boys, if you've been to Beautiful, if you've been to Dear Evan Hansen, you've heard the wonderful music of Steve Gibb. And then no slouch himself from Long Island, from Long Island? From Brooklyn now. One of the top fiddle champions of the world, a Glenfiddich Scottish fiddle champion, Mr. Callum Pasqua, to play a traditional tune for us. Thank you. Steve Gibbon, Callum Pasqua. Gentlemen, thank you. There you go. There you go. We're going to ask Jillian Hassert to join us again on stage. And she's going to sing a wonderful, inspirational song from a show that's coming back to Broadway this fall, if I'm not mistaken. Jillian, am I not? I read my New York Times correctly, and that is, You'll Never Walk Alone. Jillian.
Thank you.
It's been an amazing night. Jillian sang You'll Never Walk Alone, which is from Carousel.
Absolutely.
She did a beautiful job.
Gorgeous.
She,
and we've had pianist Mark Yellick with us all evening. He's the supervisor of music and visual arts from South Orange and Maplewood. And he previously taught music at the Riverdale Regional School District. Most recently, his work is centered around recitals and he's certainly an accomplished professional, you can tell.
And also we had Callum Pasqua, who is from Brooklyn, New York.
Oh, he was the fiddle player.
Yes, he was the fiddle player. He, in 2007, Callum was the very first American to be invited to participate in the Glenfiddich Scottish Fiddle Competition at Blair Castle, where he was earned first prize. And in 2008, he was declared Fiddler to the Marquis of Huntly, a competition that was resurrected from 150 years ago.
Thank you. And once again, we want to thank Bob. We want to thank Hometown Television. We want to thank Central Presbyterian Church. But most of all, we want to thank you for donating to the Red Cross this evening. If you haven't had a chance yet, all you need to do is text the word Harvey to 90999. It will be $10. You won't even feel it. No amount is too little. No amount is too great. You can find out more information at redcross.org. You can set up a monthly giving program, or you can find out how to volunteer in your own community. We could use plenty of help right here in New Jersey.
And
fantastic. I'm Shane Miller. It's been our privilege this evening to host this telethon with you.
And I'm Amy Prisbilko. Thank you.
And we've got one last word from the Red Cross. Thank you so much for joining us on Hometown Television.
Have a good night.
The American Red Cross is here on the ground in Texas, and we've been here since before Harvey made landfall. The immediate response of support has been overwhelmingly generous, and thousands of Red Cross volunteers from all across the country came to Texas and dropped everything to help others. The American people open their hearts, and the Red Cross is staffing dozens of shelters to house tens of thousands of people every single night. And we're providing comfort, care, and hope to people who lost everything. Huge disasters like Hurricane Harvey are extremely difficult. We're always there, and we always want to do the right thing. And it's in that spirit that I want to address the topic with you directly. To set the record straight, it's the issue of donations and where the money donated to Hurricane Harvey response is going. During these early days, donations are being used to set up shelters and command centers to manage our volunteer operations, like the one right behind me. Donations pay for cots, they pay for blankets, food, water, and relief supplies, like hygiene kits, diapers, and wheelchairs. Donations pay to get volunteers to these shelters, whether by plane, bus, or by car. Donations pay for the gas to power our emergency response vehicles, some 200 of them at last count, that will help distribute food and water in the coming days. Donations pay to provide vehicles, warehouses, technology, and the people that make all of this help possible for Hurricane Harvey survivors. Americans work hard for their money, and that's why we're committed to being the very best stewards of our donors' dollars. We keep our expenses low, and 91 cents of every dollar we spend for this disaster will go to help the people affected by Hurricane Harvey, and we're really very proud of the fact that our overhead is low. I'm also proud that the top two charity watchdog organizations, the Better Business Bureau and Charity Navigator, both give us their highest ratings for accountability and transparency. As these days turn into weeks, we'll work one-on-one with impacted individuals and families to help them get back on their feet. Cash donations will help people buy what they need and put money back in the local economy here where it will be needed most. And because massive disasters like Hurricane Harvey create more demands than any one organization could possibly meet, we'll work to find people help from our incredible partners. And once the emergency phase of this disaster passes, any remaining donations will go to meet the longer-term needs of the communities affected by Harvey and help them rebuild. Our donors should be proud of how their donations have been used to help save lives and support people during some of the darkest days imaginable. It truly is America at its best. The American Red Cross and our volunteers are proud to be a part of this response, and we stand with the people of Texas. And I want to thank those of you that have made donations. We're going to put them to really good use. Thank you.
Well, there's just enough time now to thank you all for coming on this musical fundraising ride with us. I do want to thank our company, Rev. Stephan Jubilation, and you may applaud, Jillian Hassert and Wayne Millett, Pipers from the Rampant Lion Pipe Band, the Shot of Scotch Highland Dancers, guitarist Steve Gibb, fiddler Callum Pasqua, singer-juggler extraordinaire John Grimaldi, and pianist Mark Yalak. Thank you all very much. I also want to add a special thank you to our friends at Central Presbyterian Church for hosting this concert this evening. I want to thank the incredible hard work that happened behind the scenes with all of our partners at Hometown Television, Summit's great community partner for local community access television, and the Summit Area Red Cross for also lending their support and being behind this. Thank you. We wish all of our friends well wherever they are, and that bright skies and warm food and dry beds come their way soon. Hallelujah.
There was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, hallelujah. Baby, I've been here before. I've seen the room, I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew you. And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 For me there's a God above, but all I ever learned from love was how to shoot someone who outdrew you. And it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
Are saying that this hurricane will be a prolonged event.
Already 200,000 people are without power. has been the first major hurricane to hit the U.S. since 2005. That's been a real shock and some hard times for people.
The waters keep rising, and according to the National Weather Service, the city is now facing an unprecedented flood event.
The water, it really does seem to be everywhere. So far, we're hearing two deaths blamed on the storm, but there are still many more people who need help.
Several places have already seen more than 9 inches of rain from Harvey. Much more is ahead. At last check, more than 200,000 people in this region were without power.
So we're going to do everything we can to rescue anybody that needs to be rescued, but keep everybody safe.